You may find yourself operating to a custom loss limit. Either you're testing a single fiber, or the consultant or end user, or indeed the cabling manufacturer has specified a loss limit that's tied to them what the standards actually require. In this case, my calculated loss limit is 1.27 dB for both 1310 and 1550. It's quite a short link. To do that, we need to change the test limit. So we'll tap the test limit here, new test. Make sure the module type says CertiFiber Pro. If it doesn't, tap module and change it to the CertiFiber Pro module that you're using. We're using a quad here. And then since we're changing the test limit, we'll tap test limit, more, and custom, manage, and we'll go and create one. We'll give it a name first of all. We'll call it trunk 01. Now, when you look at this, you'll notice under loss budget, there's two flavors. One is fixed and one is length based. The length based customization allows you to take the default 0.75 dB allowed for a mated pair and say change it to half a dB or 0.35 or whatever your consultant or end user or indeed cabling vendor says. We've actually got a fixed loss for this one. It's specifically 1.27 at both wavelengths. So when we change it to fixed, we just get simply the option to enter in those losses. So I'll tap 1310. 1.27, done. 1550, 1.27, done. That's my two wavelengths selected there. I'll tap save. Here is my custom limit. Important to actually select it now. And since this is single mode, let's change the fiber type to single mode. So I'm in smart remote mode. I could change that to far in source mode if I was testing a single fiber, but I'll leave it in smart remote. And everything else here is good. So save. Here is my new test setup. Use selected, and I'm ready to go. In the current version of firmware that I'm using here, you're allowed to put in up to 20 custom fiber optic limits for the CertiFiber Pro.